Hi, this is Dawn.
I'm Matt.
And we're with Seven Is Enough, and today we're gonna take you to
the Jesse James Farm Museum. And the farmhouse, it's still here. So, and it's a pretty neat museum.
It is, it is. We've actually been here a few times.
We took the kids here a few weeks ago and filmed it, and somebody, won't say who, lost the footage.
I think it's that stinking elf on a shelf took it.
Really cool. I've been watching the video, I didn't want to talk too loud, but look at these boots worn by Zerelda Cole. Who was Jesse James' mom. And she married Robert James, and that's his shaving mirror. That's cool.
I love the embroidered sampler.
Oh, I do too. Is that, that's Jesse's mom's? Yeah.
Yeah, that's cool. And then
Zerelda Cole.
Written by Robert to Zerelda. 1841.
Why did they call them samplers? Anyway,
good question.
I've always wondered that. Now, he was a minister at New Hope Church, which I would like to go see. I think it's still there, isn't it?
And this is Jesse's dad.
Yes, this is Jesse James's dad, who ended up going to California during the gold rush, and then he died there, I believe.
Oh, that's cool. The letters and essays. Open that.
Oh.
Oh, so cool.
Oh, that's cool.
You can.
For people like you with bad eyes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's pretty neat.
That is neat. Wow. That's really cool. That's him. That would be Jesse James's dad. And here's. See, the church is still there. That's what it looks like today.
Very neat. The James Family Bible. Oh, I'd love to look through that. Flip in there and see if they underlined the way we do.
I don't know. Jesse probably should have read it more.
I agree. I think Jesse James is a perfect example of how God can use you. However, if you don't, you know, forgive and let go of your bitterness, the devil can destroy your life. So here are some of the movies.
Yeah, and here's where they show a video of Jesse James, and they have movie posters on the wall from a lot of the old Jesse James movies. And some of them, quite a few of them I've seen actually.
And the last time we were here, video footage disappeared, but the last time we were here, the actress who played Jesse's mom was here as well.
Yeah. Yeah, we get to meet her. That was neat. So let's, some of these posters are really cool. All right. This one I've seen. It's Randy Travis, Rob Lowe, and Bill Paxton are all in it. It's Frank and Jesse. It's not that great a movie, but I have seen it. What?
Not that crazy.
No.
I think I've seen it and I think I liked it.
I remember the sound effects were kind of lame. The Outlaws is coming. The Three Stooges. This one's probably the best Jesse James movie of all. Jesse James meets Frankenstein's daughter. Don't you think? I haven't seen it. I kind of want to watch it. This one, believe it or not, is one of my favorites. The Last Days of Frank and Jesse James. It has Johnny Cash, Kris Kristofferson, and Willie Nelson. And it's actually really good. I think Johnny Cash plays Frank.
Cool.
But it's really, The Long Riders is my favorite Jesse James movie. Have you ever seen it, babe?
Yeah.
It's really good. I love it. They have all, oh, here's a picture of it from the movie. That's the best Jesse James movie. If you've only seen one, see that one.
Didn't they come here?
I don't know, but I do know that all the brothers, they were all actual brothers that played in the movie.
Oh! So the Keeches, right?
The Keeches played the Jameses, and the Youngers were played by the Quades.
Yep.
And the Guest Brothers were in it. They played what's his name? The one that killed Jesse James. They played those the brothers, Bob Ford and Rob.
The coward whose name is too.
Yeah, but I don't remember his brother's name, but the Ford brothers. And but anyway, all brothers play in the movie. It's really cool.
That's a play.
Assassination of Jesse James.
That was a good one.
That's a really good one. That one's pretty darn accurate. That was good.
I love the title. By the cowardly Robert Ford.
Yeah.
Isn't he cute? He's a cutie. Pretty sure you were about the same height as Jesse's mom. She looks a little meaner.
Tall.
Yeah, 6 foot.
It's hard to tell Frank with his big hat on.
Yeah. Donated in 1988.
That's Jesse
by
James.
By the granddaughter of Jesse.
Yes, yeah, his Jesse James's shotgun is in there. And the boots he was wearing when he died. Those are the boots he was actually wearing. And what else? A cartridge belt belonged to Jesse. And a handkerchief.
There it is.
Yeah, that's his handkerchief. So he carried one of the rebels. Palmer carried another. Guerrilla soldier. Bloody Bill Anderson.
Civil War.
Yeah, and Quantrill. All guerrillas.
So if you're coming to Missouri, you can see where we are.
Frank was at the Battle of Wilson's Creek in Lexington.
So St. Louis, Jefferson City, Kansas City, and then we are here.
Yep. Yep. This is where they had to evacuate. That's where Pappinsville is, Rich Hill and all that, is in Bates.
They made all
they had
the...
To, they had to evacuate all those. At least Bates...
The Union the burnt, came in and made them
yeah,
leave,
they called
right?
the Burnt District. Yeah, they totally made them leave, and because it was all Southern sympathy in that area. These are a pair of Jesse James's spurs and a glove, a riding glove. And over here, babe, is what's left of his original coffin. Because he was originally buried at the farm, and that was the coffin he was buried in, and these are parts from the coffin after the wood rotted. And this bullet fragment, they actually found that in the grave. They think it was left in there when he was shot, either during the Civil War or the Northfield Raid.
Picture of him.
Yeah, in fact, see that In God We Trust? That's the picture he was said to be, he was straightening that picture when he was shot. He was basically was holding
dusting.
That, yeah, that feather duster, that actual one, and he was standing up on that chair, and he was straightening that picture, and all that is the real deal.
You know what I take away from this?
Don't straighten pictures when your enemies are.
He helped his wife clean.
Yeah.
Even a scoundrel yeah. helps his wife clean.
I think it was neat they found that bullet in that grave, though.
I do, too. I love how you change the subject so quickly. Tried in Gallatin, Missouri, Frank James.
Yep, and he was acquitted.
Gallatin's not too far from here.
No.
About an hour. This is?
This is a model of the first daylight bank robbery that occurred in Liberty, Missouri by the James Gang. And I actually made this model. I made a small model. My dad used to give tours here, and I made a small model for that museum, and they liked it. So they asked me to make this big one, and it took me a while. But I pretty much sculpted all the figures. The buildings are all scratch built, and the ground, all of it I did. And then they had somebody else paint the background. But anyway.
How long did it take you to do that?
I don't remember it. It took me months. I know that. It took me quite a while. And I got pictures of all the real buildings, like this white hotel over here was actually there at the time, and there was pictures of it. So I based the building off of those pictures. And the bank.
I love the little stuff inside.
Yeah, I actually added interiors to all of it. Even the bank has interiors, even though you can't see them.
No, I wish you'd have made a little open spot.
Yeah, and if you look back here, I even put an outhouse back there. And the James Gang that day came in wearing Union Army coats. So that's why you see them wearing those. They were disguised basically as Union, in Union uniforms.
There's and they shot and William killed Jewell College up there.
Yep, William Jewell College was up the hill. And that they actually shot somebody that was in the street, and that's, he was right at the foot of those stairs.
Pretty cool.
Yeah. It's my favorite.
And we will
guy.
Take you.
My favorite guy has the red shirt on. I just like the way he came out.
zoom in.
Yeah, I like him.
Yeah.
I thought it came out pretty good. Oh, and I forgot. Yeah. Holding bank bags. Jesse James Anderson.
Pretty cool.
Has killed many a man.
Alleged robberies.
He robbed the Union.
So I also have a Jesse James story. My grandma rented, my great grandma rented a room upstairs in Liberty, Missouri to Jesse James. She used to tell my mom that he was a good boy and that he was blamed for stuff that he didn't do, because she says that he was up sleeping one day when...
I'm sure he was blamed for some stuff he did.
They came looking for him for...
I would probably question the good boy part.
I know.
This is a model of the James house, the farmhouse, which we're going to go see in a minute. It's still there. That's what... but that's what it looked like back in the day while they were robbing.
And then this back part is what caught on fire.
Yeah, the Pinkertons.
Right over there, I believe, right?
No, it was on the other side, I believe.
Okay. So back over here.
Yeah. Yes. The Pinkertons raided, and they threw in like a smoke pot, but it was like a round thing filled with fuel to smoke them out. And Zerelda Samuel, Jesse James' mom, they think kicked it in the fireplace.
It was a bomb or something.
And it blew up, and it blew her arm off, and it killed their stepbrother. He was young and simple-minded, and it killed him.
Oh. Here's a picture of her.
Here's a picture of her, and you can see there's
no arm.
Empty. Oh, and here's, when you're done there.
I can imagine.
Here's the actual, what's left, half of the bomb that they threw in. You can see where it exploded. That's half of it. There would have been another half.
That was a picture of the cabin with her there.
Yep. Her in the front yard.
Did you say it killed the son?
Yes. Killed their younger stepbrother. Oh, this was
Frank James with his dog.
Yeah, but this was his horse, Dan, right? What she told us was Dan was, Dan was buried in the front yard, and when Frank James got older, he wanted to go visit the grave. They put a little gravestone for him.
He would go out.
He would go out and visit him, but as he got older, he couldn't go far, so they kept moving the stone closer to the house. And so now they have no idea where the horse was buried.
So he didn't have to walk so far.
Yeah, so now they've lost the site. They don't really know where.
So somewhere there is horse bones.
Now this was the original tombstone memorial to Jesse James when he was buried in the front yard. And as you can see, people have chipped away at it over the years and took souvenirs. They ended up moving his body, and he's now buried in Kearney, which is a bigger town just near here. That's where he's buried today. But originally, he was buried in the front yard here at the James Farm.
Yeah, we're about maybe 4 or 5 minutes, 8 minutes maybe, from downtown Kearney where he's buried.
And we've been there. We may do a video and show you where he's buried.
Yeah, my grandma's buried there.
Yeah. In the same graveyard.
Same graveyard.
And your grandpa.
Yep. Grandma and grandpa. Don't say it.
Somebody chipped it
that one too.
I know.
Oh, Lord. That's what is that?
This is a... Oh, this was his, yeah, that's right, this is Frank James's robe.
That's in style today for women.
I have one just like that, wear around the house with a pipe.
There's a lot of stuff here. I'm going to go faster because, you know, people, you need to come visit. He loved to golf.
Mm-hmm. And he said it was a 9-hole golf course. But when people got there was only 3 holes. He said, you just go through it 3 times.
Yeah, go do it again.
Do it. That's funny.
Membership card.
To the James Farm Golf Club. Wonder how many people were members of it, actually.
It's awesome. So, we just came from the museum. And you get this nice little path to walk down to the house. And the last tree right down there is Matt's dad Fred's memorial tree. So they do all these trees in memory of different people who've participated in some way with the James Farm.
Okay. Oh, he didn't get over.
Oh, we were just talking. It's a picture of my dad's tree in memory of Fred Coons. He died in 2010, and he used to volunteer out here and give tours and did it for years. But anyway, she was telling me like the different people that's out here that has a tree.
Like Yateman, he wrote the most popular book about Jesse and Frank. It's called Frank and Jesse James.
I think I've read it.
Yeah, it's a very factual book.
Yes.
We found one error. I think it's a day. I can't remember if it's Jesse's birthday is incorrect. It's off by just, not the year's not off. I think it's the day.
The day. I think my dad, I believe that's the book he gave me, and I read it, and it was really good. This is the James Farm, the Jesse James Farm.
They don't allow pictures inside the house, so you will have to come visit if you want to see inside. They're actually fixing, because from the last time we were here, they've boarded the windows.
Yes, they're doing renovations, which we're going to show you over here. The siding that was put on, I think, after the Civil War, they've removed a lot of that siding, and you can actually see the actual logs.
Which is so very cool, because
this was the way it originally looked when it was built.
Yeah.
And you haven't been able to see that
for our entire lives. When we've come out here to
the white
view it, we've always seen this.
Yeah.
So this
is neat to see.
It's super cool to see up close. And on the other side, you're going to get to see some burn areas.
Yeah, I'm going to show you before we do that. So this would have been the front porch, but over here is where
this would have been the front porch.
Yeah, that would have been the front porch area. In the living room. Over here is where Jesse James was originally buried. And in the museum, we actually saw what was left of the tombstone memorial.
Which was 8 feet, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was tall. But the souvenir hunters had chipped away at it over the years, so they have put a new one up in its place, and what's left of the old one's in the museum now.
But it says the same.
Yeah, and the footstone is still here. This is the original, I believe. And this is where the pebbles would have been that they used to sell to the tourists were on this grave. And so they ended up taking Jesse James' body out and moved him to the Kearney Cemetery, which is where he's currently buried. Devoted husband and father, Jesse Woodson James, September 5th, 1847, murdered April 3rd, 1882, by a traitor and coward whose name is not worthy to appear here. Which is Robert Ford, I'll just say. In the 90s, they dug up Jesse James's grave again. My dad was actually there when they did it. And they did DNA testing to prove once and for all that it was actually Jesse James, because for years, this old guy had come forward and said he was really Jesse James. He was not murdered, Yeah. But it was proven to be not true. That really was Jesse James buried there in Kearney.
And here is the area where
the
he
golf
would,
course.
Yeah, he had three holes of golf out there. Now they use that area for shooting.
Yeah, black powder shooting.
Black powder shooting.
Yeah, it's been here almost 200 years.
The original pump from the 1820s.
Which they did not smoke, they used it for rope making. And they grew tobacco, which they did smoke. They had wheat and corn and many livestock. They had chickens and they originally had 275 acres. We have 40 of that original 25.
Wow.
But this may be what you guys want to take a picture of if you can.
Oh, yeah, the birds.
The Pinkertons popped a bomb in here that maimed Zerelda and killed little Archie Samuel, Frank and Jesse's youngest sibling, his third little half-brother. And the James brothers weren't even here at the time, which was really sad. You guys can't walk in here, but I want to show you something. So when the bomb was thrown in that window right there and landed on the floor, which flooring's been tore up, It sat here for quite a while, and the family's like, this is an explosive. They tossed it into the fireplace, which Zerelda's stove would have been over there, probably hoping that it would blow up into the chimney. It didn't. When it blew up, it filled the room with shrapnel. But this is the scorch mark from that bomb from 1875.
Wow.
Clear into that old floor joist.
So that is, this is a wraparound fireplace. You can see through it. And this is their bedroom.
Did you guys want to walk back through the house?
Yeah.
Okay, this over here, that is now the bathrooms, that would have been the carriage house where they kept their carriage. And then this would have been the smokehouse.
Yeah, and Dan lived in the carriage house.
Yeah, the horse, yeah. And then out here is their slave quarters, because the James family had slaves.
Show us where Dan, she originally pointed and said like Dan was probably out here somewhere.
Yes, I think buried out here somewhere, but they don't know exactly where because they moved.
And that's why as he got older and didn't want to walk as far from the house, they kept moving it and moving it and moving it. It's so funny.
Jesse James.
And the slaves, they had a family of five, correct?
I think so, yeah. And they lived out here.
So after the slaves were freed, after the war, and the slaves were freed.
Yeah, they stayed out here. They just stayed on and worked with the
family.
They
lived with the family, Yeah. Stayed.
Okay, so we end with the Jesse James gift shop, and they have a lot of great stuff in here. A lot of really good books on the Civil War and Jesse James in particular, which I own some of these books. A lot of good books on the Guerrilla War in Missouri. And I was pointing at that one because I've read that one. That was really good. Some of these books I own and I have not read, but a few of them I've read. The Bushwhackers there. I own that one, and that's really good. There's actually a lot of stuff in the gift shop. They sell t-shirts and movies and different things for the kids.
Toys. Stuffed animals.
Yes.
Games.
Games. And
puzzles.
puzzles, and they have, you like that one part they have in there.
They do. I do love that part.
Yeah, you kind of wish we had that.
Thanks for watching. We would love to have you hit that like button if you like what you saw, and if you'd like to see more, hit the subscribe button, and if you ding that bell, you will get notifications when we release new videos.
Have a great day, and thanks for watching.
We love ya.
Don is talking as normal. Yeah.